You think I'm crying on my own? Well, I ain't.
That sound like Kanye doing that, man.
And I didn't want to write a song.
Ow!
Like, someone can straight up make you think that they got the Kanye feature.
A lot goes into making a great song. The lyrics, beats, delivery, and a lot of nuanced vocal characteristics. It's a science, and for those who've mastered the craft, they are really, really good at it. From Michael Jackson to Beyonce to Kanye West. If you haven't been caught up on all the AI-generated music cloned in the style of your favorite artists, then you're in the right place. If you're all caught up, you're still in the right place. In this video, I'll explain the behind-the-scenes workings of some of these AI models. Some of the fun ones I've seen have been the Kanye West versions, and this one by David Guetta at one of his shows.
This is the future rave sound. I'm getting lost in an underground. This is the future rave sound. I'm getting lost in an underground.
There's something that I made as a joke and it works so good, I could not believe it.
Incredible, right? I thought it was an actual Eminem feature the first time I heard it, but apparently it's Eminem. And of course, expect the quality to get much, much better in the coming years. Obviously, we can't complete this discussion without mentioning the elephant in the room, copyright and the meaning of identity in music. We'll talk about this at the end of the video. For now, let's talk about the fun stuff. If you're amazed by this technology and want to understand how it works, then I'm ready to walk you through it. Let's dive in right away. I thought I'd make an explainer video like this because I know a lot of people are wondering how this AI music thing works. One of the popular examples has been Roberto Nixon's YouTube tutorial, where you see him convert his voice to Kanye's.
You might notice that I sound like Kanye West.
Here's an example of him singing day and night.
Wild stuff. How does he do this? Well, it begins by opening this collab notebook. It's a platform for running machine learning code. You import your original recording, then run all the code and replace a portion of the code with Kanye's AI voice model. I won't go over all the steps, that's not the purpose of this video. Rather, we want to understand the mechanisms behind this. Let's reveal the wizard behind the curtain. I tracked the code of the AI music converter to understand the inner workings of the code. One thing you should know before we get into all the details is that computers understand only numbers. Whether it's text, images, or audio, all of that is converted into numbers for the machine to understand. The main model used here is the Singing Voice Conversion Model, or SVC. After you record your music in your own voice, you have to pass it on to this model. This is the first step. The initial step of the model extracts your words and how you're saying them. This is done by a sub-AI model called SoftVC, or Soft Voice Conversion. The extracted voice component is transformed into numbers. Remember, that's how the computer understands. The model is then passed onto the VITS model along with the artist's voice you want to use. This is where the voice is actually converted. The model learns the right pitch, cadence, loudness, and general acoustics of the artist's unique voice. Here are examples of voice conversion from the VITS research blog.
The rainbow is a division of white light into many beautiful colors.
The rainbow is a division of white light into many beautiful colors.
The rainbow is a division of white light into many beautiful colors.
The rainbow is a division of white light into many beautiful colors.
You see that from one voice, you can transform it to another while maintaining its original content. This is the same technique applied in AI music conversion. The same lyrics in two different voices will spark different emotions in us. When it comes to music, voice is everything. That's why we have writers in the music industry, because they are master wordsmiths. But at the end of the day, we want to hear a unique voice sing out the lyrics to us. That's why the right voice matters. After the VITS model stage, we're left with one more model, the DiffSinger. The DiffSinger model is trained on a singing dataset, meaning it has learned how the human singing voice works. Here's a singing data sample used in training the model. The DiffSinger vocoder transforms the output of the previous VITS model into a very realistic singing voice. The final output is converted from a male spectrogram to a wave output. meaning that the voice is now converted to the right frequency for the artist's singing voice. The waveform is the actual sound signal that we can hear. This three-stage model approach is all wrapped up in our main SVC model. This is how the code works behind the scenes. I know I've revealed how the magic really works, but that still doesn't take away from the incredible work and innovation of this approach. This work has been an iterative process over the years, built on the backs of previous research papers and open source work from different universities and collaborators. An easier approach others are using is signing up for Uberduck AI or other services like it and getting access to thousands of unique voices, including custom ones of artists. Here's an example you can listen to on their page.
Rap, you had a great year, then we got the stats. We gave out over 3 million in cash, not just whack track facts. This year you won $14, that's a man's stat.
MNAIM doing its thing again. You can find Michael Jackson, Justin Bieber, and a host of other celebrity voices. I tested out an example with Lady Gaga's voice by simply typing the text. Don't judge me on my songwriting abilities. I promise I could do much better. Here's the output.
This is the new age of technology. Will stand with me. I break records with this new technology. I go all out and that's my philosophy. Yee.
For now, it's not the best, and I suspect the pricing models would have better customizations. It seems this version of Uberduck I used is based on Google's text-to-speech model from 2017, Tachotron 2. There are much better models now that capture better audio information. For now, it seems the best way to mimic a voice is to record in your own voice and then do conversion afterwards, like in the SVC method we discussed earlier. In the future, it should be easy to simply let the AI generate thousands of ways of singing the lyrics. It's crazy to imagine such a world, but we're well on our way. In the past years, we've seen the use of AI technologies for other artists like Travis Scott and Jay-Z. These sometimes turn out to be huge copyright battles, and we'll definitely see more and more of them very soon. It calls for the meaning of identity and ownership. On the human side, how do you effectively argue that your voice is being replicated? If I change the pitch just a little bit to make it sound very similar, but not exactly, do I get a pass? On the other end, AI music owners will probably have to provide their creation process. What voice data did you use to generate the music? And do you have rights to it? For music companies, it may affect how contracts are signed in the future. There may be clauses that grant access to artists' voices, so in times of inability to record, or in extreme cases like death, we can still hear new music from them. Imagine Michael Jackson, Prince, or Whitney Houston still making songs, especially on current topics, with AI-generated voices. It would be a bit unsettling, wouldn't it? How would fans react to songs from deceased artists using AI? These are all questions we would have to answer sooner rather than later. And governments would have to get in front of this as soon as possible. Many people worry that the creative process of recording a song could be lost forever, especially since these AI systems are getting better and better at an exponential rate. The barrier for entry into music will be lowered even more, especially if anyone can just write a piece of text and then get a song out of it. Maybe I'm being a bit optimistic, but I believe the creative process may be transformed in some way in the future, and not necessarily lost forever. Our taste and preferences will definitely change. Who knows, there may still be a market for human-recorded songs, just like how some people prefer handcrafted rocks to machine-manufactured ones. What do you think about AI music? Would you try it out? Let me know in the comments. Before you leave, make sure to check out this video about the state of AI audio. It's closely related to this topic. You'll hear unbelievable sound quality. Thanks for watching, and until the next video, it's goodbye.